Alright, we're back. I think we're back. We look like we're back. Excellent. We're back for part two. People have been working on their characters. Kai probably already is working on like his fifth or sixth character by now. Just, he's ready to go through lots of dead people. He knows how this works. Okay, I'm doing some backstory work about some political stuff going on in the background because this is Game of Thrones. While we're making characters, I should probably take some notes on this. How hard do you guys want this game to be? And I know I always say, like, do you want it to be super easy or do you want it to be super hard? And everyone's like, let's take the middle ground. Right. How middle ground do you want this to be?
Middle low.
Middle ground on the side of slightly easy.
But okay.
Yes.
Because so Arthur isn't brutal, so I've learned that, you know, that will be real ground.
Yeah, so we expect you to be on the high end, so we're asking you to put on the middle low ground of what you think is middle low.
Exactly.
Physical well-being. Oh yeah, I need that to be high for sure.
Okay. For the political side, how well do you want me to explain what's going on? And by that I mean, so this is spoilers for the first book of Game of Thrones, but the entire first book of Game of Thrones is about the incest storyline and everyone discovering it in parts, and then Cersei covering it up and then flipping it all on Ned Stark and killing him for it. So, I mean, it was not well explained. Like, all the parts were there, but no one really knew what was going on. And then at the end, it was all explained. It was like, Cersei was behind everything. I'm Ned Stark, and I figured it all out, and I'm telling everyone, and oh, no, I'm in prison, and now my head's chopped off. I mean, like, how complex do you want these intrigues to be?
I want them pretty complex.
Let me use a scale. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 would be a TV show on the CW, and a 10 would be George R. R. Martin.
7.
Right, I just
5 or 6. 6, 6. I know, but 6.
Yeah, I mean, do you have, like, a representative work of fiction I could use as a... For instance, I would put the Watergate scandal, I would put that at like a 7 or 8. They tried really hard to keep all that shit cut. Nixon in the tapes.
Then probably 6, just below the Watergate scandal.
Alright. Level of complexity. Just below Watergate.
I was happy with what being in Pendragon, I think, was like about the level I think we'd want it to be at.
Yeah.
I would rate that at about a 4 or 5.
Wanted more complex than that.
The mechanics have more complexity.
I didn't understand anything about the politics in Pendragon until I saw a map.
Yeah. I'm going to have to create a map for this one. I knew as soon as we chose Game of Thrones, I was like, I'm going to have a map. It's interesting. I'm the map.
Yeah.
Oh, and status, is that like... So like for me, I probably have a 4 because I'm a maester.
Yeah.
Does that mean I have to buy a 4?
Yes.
Okay.
If you don't want to have a 4, you don't have to. I'm not going to...
No, I'm going to put it up to a 4 since I'm a maester.
And you can look at putting some bonuses in as well.
Yeah. See, I'm not gonna be a thief. I let me look at thievery again because I want
to
make.
Dump thievery for
I don't want to dump thievery if I don't. If it's like has some other aspect on
your
very
first mission you get sent on, it's gonna be nothing but thievery, and everyone's gonna be like, I don't know how to open this door. How do I do this? Your first mission is to take a key card off of a card. You guys are just like, I stabbed the guard to death. I'm really good at doing that. I'm the best!
Luckily, the thing is, I don't think we'll be sent on that mission.
No, probably not.
Considering we're guardsmen, it's all into things like that.
Okay, let me know when you guys are finished setting up your abilities. We'll then talk about destiny points and flaws.
I finished 5 hours ago.
Of course.
Actually, I finished like 6 months ago on this guy.
I'm actually going to probably have to change my vice pretty soon, but
okay, that's fine.
Based on how I'm statting myself up.
I created this character the first time we even mentioned the Game of Thrones when we were choosing to do Pendragon.
That was a while ago.
So this guy's been around before Pendragon.
So since all of you are adults and young adults, you're going to have... Young adults have 5 destiny points, adults have 4, and you both have 3 maximum benefits. None of you have any flaws, actually. Adults have any one flaw.
I actually have a flaw.
Yeah, because you're an adult, so you get to pick any one flaw.
It's language flaw.
you son of a bitch.
What?
What is the flaw for language? I hope it's you have trouble speaking common, because that would be amazing.
We're not allowed to touch language, right? We're ignoring it as a thing.
It's not that you should or should not ignore it. It's that you probably shouldn't do anything with it.
Wait, no. Language flaw, I think, just makes me take -1D on language.
That's, you're very difficult for you to communicate with anyone. Yeah.
You stutter a lot.
Though I'm very good at convincing. I'm actually very good at persuasion.
To read at the most basic level, you need to have 3 in language, which means most people can't even read.
I can. I just... No, our
the way they set up language in this game was absolute poor. It's one of the biggest complaints. Like, go on any forum, and everyone's like, "Yep, language sucks."
So, what is the effect of having an extra flaw?
Choose another Latif.
You don't have an extra flaw, right? You just have 1 flaw.
No, you only have if you're an adult, you have 1.
These aren't vices; these are flaws. You have to actually pick one.
Yeah. So. There was already 1 designated for Anointed Knight because we decided I was going to be the bastard.
Yep.
You can take another benefit if you take
swap it to bastard. Yeah.
Okay.
What are specialties?
Specialties are like you're good with longswords, which means when you're fighting with longswords, you get extra dice.
So
but
how
it,
do you?
It doesn't. You don't actually add it up. It's like you get to choose the better of them.
Yes, it's basically it's a bonus keeping dice, the highest out of all the dice that are rolled.
Is it, and how do you choose like a specialty? Like what happens?
So there's long blades.
It's right after
if you use character sheet I sent you.
I see the list of them, but I'm not sure how to
it's on page 67. It talks you through it.
Okay, that's fine.
So when it says,
"What age are you, by the way, Kroama?"
Young adult.
Young adult.
Yep.
Are you the maester?
In young adult.
Is there an exception? Yeah.
You're 14. Like you're between like you're like a 16-year-old maester.
Hey, 16 maester. Is young adult. I thought young adult would be like 20.
No.
No, 20 is adult.
Yeah.
20 is almost. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think I have to be an adult. 18, I was
18.
Okay. 18. I was thinking I was like a 20 kind of person. I didn't know it'd be.
Middle age is 30. It's pretty low.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
They die quickly in this world. Remember that.
Definitely.
Milk of the poppy.
I have to change
being
to be.
The oldest known is like 80. It's called venerable. You get old at age 50, our age for middle age.
Gosh,
yeah, young adults are 14 to 18. I guess that's what you'd consider a young adult in our culture.
Okay. So if I'm going to be an adult, that gives me 30 more points here. That's right, because I was wrong before. Oh, shoot. That's tempting now, though. If I'm an adult, I can go up to a 7 in healing.
You don't want to do, like...
In all of history... And I don't know how to read.
Exactly. Generally, like, you don't need stuff so much above 5 from what I'm trying to understand. Like, you having bonus dice is actually really good because you can, like, improve that thing. Yeah,
specialties don't cost that much either.
Yeah.
So specialties cost experience as well?
Yep.
Do you get experience through
the
gameplay?
There's a different experience, though.
Oh, it's a different one, so it's not the same pool?
Yeah, you have, like, 8 specialty experiences in adults.
Okay, never mind. I'll continue spinning out like this, then.
And luckily, with specialties, it's much more simple. It's just 10 for every bonus dice instead of, like, 30.
What benefits are you guys looking at taking?
Benefits? I've got Bludgeon Fighter 1 and Armor Mastery.
God, benefits. What are benefits?
What are the prerequisites on that?
Bludgeon Fighter 1?
Yeah.
Here, let me check. Blah, 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 blah.
Step 5. Okay, that's why. I haven't thought of it yet.
What page are you seeing those benefits on?
They're after page 96.
It's after abilities. I'm still trying to figure out the experience thing. I think I've almost finished that, though.
I'm pretty sure the old Targaryen maester couldn't read because he was blind.
Aemon
Targaryen.
Some say he couldn't read because he's stupid.
I'm actually the heir to the Targaryens. I'm blind as well. Don't forget to send the raven, Sam. It's literally your only job.
Yep. Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, Bludgeon Fighter 1 requires fighting 4 and Bludgeon's 2 bonus.
Specialty costs.
And Armor Mastery.
Specialty experience.
Oh, you get a free degree? Damn, that's pretty good.
Free degree in what?
So you basically sacrifice bonus dice for a free degree?
What?
Is that what Bludgeon does?
No.
Bludgeon Fighter? Oh, no?
Bludgeon Fighter 1 gives you Shattering 1 extra.
Oh, okay. I was looking at Longblade Fighter 1, sorry, yeah.
Where am I? How do you figure out your starting specialty experience?
It's on the chart, on like page 68.
As an adult, you have 80.
Okay, thank you.
Oh, the specialized,
I see it.
Yeah.
It's in the entire next chapter, though, all of the specialties.
Mm-hmm.
There's a whole separate chapter.
All my benefits are for persuasion.
Okay. So... bonus dice, and what are the specialties again? Okay. So, am I behind everybody else, or is everybody else kind of looking through this too?
Well, Kai's ahead of everybody. Kai's actually spent his time hacking into my notes, and he's already figured out all the plays, and so he's just like, completely about to wreck everyone.
I've already figured out the entire campaign.
You're like, I've already figured out his intrigue, and I'm putting a counter-intrigue in place to perfectly stop it and have us come out on top.
Our actual enemy is House Morrowind.
House Belmora.
I'm having trouble getting the sheet to do what I want, so I'm kind of behind as well.
Okay. I'm actually not using the sheet. I'm using the... I'm actually using our
sheet. Is a little annoying to like get it to
load. I'm using the house creation note sheet. I just made a tab for myself and I've just been going do.
Yeah, I noticed that. Got a tensile on that thing. How did you unlock double A, A, B, A, C, and all that?
What do you mean?
You made it go past Z.
Oh, I just added more rows.
Oh,
more
columns. That makes sense.
Mm-hmm. I made them smaller so that they're even boxes, because that's how I make things. I'll show you later.
No, I picked it up. I figured it out.
And I'll show you why later. See, healing. Education? Oh, it's a subset of knowledge. Well, he's large. Marksmanship.
Did Jackson Stonewall give his son the bastard sword to always remind him of his place?
Wow.
Holy shit. How deep is that, right? Like, so...
That is hard.
This is a kid who wants to become the greatest bastard sword fighter in all the world because his dad's like, you're a bastard. You must use this sword. Protect the house at all costs. And he's like, I will become the greatest bastard sword fighter.
That's in all the lands.
Serious level of mental fuckery right there. I love it. We'll figure out whether that's canon or not.
It is. I like it the is idea. Now. It must be. It is known.
It is known.
It is known.
That's how I annotate all of my wikis now. Someone asked me for the source, and I just put asterisk, it is known. Work for the Dothraki.
It is known.
Oh, God. That's such a... It's terrible how well that's picked up to the public, because everyone's like, it is known. Yep. Yeah. Hey, this is your guys' theme song. It's called Mountain Pass. That sounds like... I don't hear anything.
Where did Animal Cohort go? I was looking for that, damn it.
It's in the beginning of the chapter.
Yeah.
It's above the actual table.
Yeah, Animal Cohort. I know I saw on this... Am I being blind? Because it was
just
on
one animal from the following list. Dog, eagle, horse, raven, shadow cat, or wolf.
I don't know why it disappeared off this list of qualities. I had selected it earlier.
Alright, so...
Do you have the prerequisites?
I have, it just, yeah. Train. One bonus dice and train.
Alright.
Okay, there we go.
Oh, I'm a master artist. Objective authority.
Oh, that's why I'm so confused. It's right here. Sometimes I do not like you, stupid thing.
So the 1B and the 2B are bonus dice?
Yeah.
So 1, 2, 3 costs 30. I only have that much. I'm focusing a little bit much here. A little bit too much, actually. I should probably stop.
Do we have anyone who's good with social combat?
Combat determined by?
Usually, like,
deception,
it would be...
persuasion.
Yeah. I have 1 deception, but I do have a 3 persuasion.
So your social combat, you're gonna get on page 70 when you start doing derived stats, like
holy, you have 7. You took 7 in healing.
Yes, I did.
That's not
that
a great idea.
That might be really high. Yeah,
I know it's not a great idea.
Specialization.
That's why I told you this is a terrible idea. In fact, I'm putting bonus dice in each of the aspects of healing.
I guess I better include a bunch of things about healing in the game then.
No, you don't have to include anything. I just use this character unless someone's about to die.
I hope you're good at something else, because otherwise, I think.
I mean, I have a 5 in knowledge and 5 in endurance as well for some reason.
How do you have that much point? How that many points?
Because I have a few ones here and there. You start with 210, right? Because. 210, then 2s and everything. Make sure I'm doing this right. And then each, and then upgrading from that to that, from 2 to 3 costs 10. Is that right, Kai?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. I have, let me make sure that it's pulling my sums.
You're talking about specialties, right?
No, I'm talking about the core when he's looking at my stats for specialties.
Yeah, from 2 to 3 is 10, yes.
Okay,
and then each extra one is 30.
All right, yep, you're at the correct.
Okay, I'll put it down to 6, but not lower than that.
Not lower than ridiculously high.
Exactly. So diagnose. Sorry, I got distracted. I was in the middle of something else, and then I had to check my work to make sure I'm not cheating. I mean, if I get caught in a fight, I think I'll live for a while, but I'll die really easily.
No, you won't. You'll die
very quickly.
Okay.
You'll die in like one turn, maybe two.
What does endurance represent?
Not dying.
Health and not dying. Converting hits into injuries, yeah.
But it only adds, it's only addition, so not much.
Yeah.
So, I mean, combat is a lot like entry. You don't have to enter it if you don't want to. Basically, you're like stakes. If the combat characters lose, then gore the prize. So if the maester doesn't want to enter combat but he loses, he probably gets taken captive by the winners.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense to me. Yeah. I'm not like...
Because by the same point, when you enter into an intrigue combat, it's typically, unless you're entering into a complex intrigue, it's going to be you versus somebody else. And their goal might be to compel someone in your party into service, so it's literally you fighting on their behalf.
Okay. So you want somebody that can find out information is what you were talking about.
I mean, convince. We want someone who can do
bargain, combat. Charm, convince. See, I was thinking of persuasion as one of the of like, come on, look at inside your soul. Why would you not help this man?
Sure.
That kind of thing. So that'd be convince.
That would and persuasion. Be persuasion.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking when I grabbed it.
Yeah, I mean, persuasion's a skill, and then charm or convince would be the. Look inside. Well, charm is or convince is literally using logic to, as in attack or defense.
And charm would be like look inside your soul.
The charm is kind of being friendly, actually. So you want to make someone. Yeah, it's just being nice to people, basically.
See, what are the other specialties before I blow my load in one spot?
Oh boy.
It's really easy to do in this character creation.
Yeah. They also tell you not to focus too much on one thing because that'll make you really weak and very, like, one-trick pony.
I feel like If you've
got something up to 5, it's really good. Like, it's 5 is really good.
So I put a 5 in a few things, actually. I have a 5 in knowledge, just because I feel like that's appropriate for a maester that's seeking knowledge about healing. And also in endurance for reasons related to my backstory.
Okay.
And then I put a 4 in a bunch of other things that also feel appropriate, like persuasion, and 3s in a few things that are like awareness and cunning. But I also put 1s in like warfare.
My only 5 is actually awareness.
Fighting. Anything that has to do with like war is something I'm terrible at.
Just to be clear, guys, you are supposed to ask me before you put 1s in everything, but it sounds like everyone just went ahead and did that.
I didn't put 1s in everything.
I know you did. 1s is
supposed to get DM approval.
Yeah.
1 in animal handling, deception, and let's eat.
I should
have. Let me check the last one.
If you want, I can reduce it, but right now my 1s are only in fighting things.
Just, I would have liked a heads up so I could be like, oh, I guess everyone's putting all the skills they don't ever anticipate using to 1. Well, I hope you guys didn't all drop animal handling, because if you don't have good animal handling, you literally can't ride a fucking horse.
I have a 30.
Yeah,
it's going to make it really hard to go anywhere. You're going to have to sit in a cart.
Yeah, so
well, I did basically just animal have a modified handling, so.
Okay. So to bring this up now, Arthur, I put a 1 in all of my fighting aspects. All of the abilities are fighting as 1s. All
right.
Because I do not. Like, that is one thing I'm terrible at.
Okay.
So fighting and marksmanship.
Oh, Anash, you got the thing with the crackling again.
Okay, hang on. I know what it is. I know what it is.
Okay.
Where's that gone? It's...
He you just mute real quick while we...
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, it's like super... Yeah.
I did put a 1 in animal handling, and I think it might just be interesting. Can't ride.
Eric, I have a question real quick relating to you. You are taking anointed as a benefit, right? Because you're an anointed knight.
Yeah.
Do you have a specific sponsor in mind, or did you want it to be Lord Jackson Stonewall?
Do you have any thoughts on other potential ones?
Not really. Lord Jackson Stonewall is pretty good.
Yeah. Your father
would definitely be the person who would sponsor you.
Yeah, so that's the other reason why I dropped the rank down.
Yeah, you get a plus two to all status tests.
It's happening again.
I think it's the headset.
Okay. I gave a bonus dice to convince for persuasion as well as reputation, just because I'm known for one thing.
Alright, cool.
I think you make me feel bad for putting ones in things, but I really like that's my mindset for that was also min-maxing one thing to a point where it's not going to be point like there's no point having it that high anyway. Except for story reasons. I really feel like I need to write a full-fledged backstory for this guy though. The Chrome Dome. Yeah, I think I'll have to have that cut. The page boy cut. Not the page boy cut. What do you call it? The top buzzed.
We got your back, Anosh. I think you're muted.
What is that coming from?
What is what coming from?
I hear a lot of... He's talking about
your music.
Oh, yeah, there's music in the background.
My headset isn't plugged in for sound, so I wasn't hearing anything.
Okay.
But now it is plugged in.
And we invest in a great way to store beef, then we sell the secrets to the other houses. What is a great way to store beef? I would figure a cold cellar, right? But Henley's about to drop some knowledge on me.
Well, it's a good thing we got lots of salt. Courtesy of that disaster many years ago.
Don't sell the secrets of the beef. Oh, Stonewall shall never give up the beef.
Can you guys hear me?
Yep.
Yep.
All right.
Okay, so I finished specialties, then you move on to the abilities thing, right? That's what you guys were talking about. Step 6, flaws and drawbacks. Yeah, I need a flaw now, right? Because I'm an adult.
Yep.
Okay.
Are you an adult?
I am an adult. I do not need an adult.
I am an adult!
Okay, so an adult has... maximum benefits? This. I'll put it here for now.
So the number of bonus dice you can have for a single one, it has to be less than your skill in it.
Yes.
If that's limitation. Yep.
What drawbacks do you have, by the way, Eric? I'm interested. You took bastard. Did you take anything else?
I thought you said I could only have one as an adult.
Well, it's not that you can only have one. It's just that... you're only forced to have one. You can voluntarily take another drawback to gain one destiny point, but you cannot have more drawbacks than benefits.
I was going to essentially have the same as it had on the initial one, where it was a minus one to thieving. That's what's on the actual template, and then I was just going to add the bastard.
I was thinking the minus one to thieving at first as well, just because I didn't want to be a thief. But then I was like, you know what? It's kind of a knowledge thing, knowing how to do it. So I actually increased it to 3. I don't think dropping it to 1 just because you don't think of yourself as a thief is a good idea.
What is the flaw where you are terrible at thieving called?
I mean, I'm just looking on the thing itself.
Okay.
The flaw so
on the template.
Does it? I mean, does it list flaws on there?
So it has a list of flaw. Let's see. I'm finding the right one at the top.
What pages?
Flaw thievery minus 1D.
And what pages are flaws on? Is it like under the ability or?
What page? You mean to find the ability or
to find the flaws?
It's like page 90 something. 97 is the qualities and benefits, and then flaws start on page. Deep Lord.
All right, so
flaws on page 118.
So taking a flaw gives you an extra destiny point, which you could also spend to upgrade something.
Yes, you can take another benefit.
Let's see, where's the list of benefits?
Page 90 something. Someone should take Nemesis. You have a rival, a destructive enemy who holds you in utter contempt. The Flying Beef Storage with Great Eyesight will workshop the name.
Flaws are drawbacks, right?
Yes.
Okay, so it's the same thing. Who's your family's surname?
Also, as a young adult, can I take an extra flaw and benefit?
Yes, but you... Yes, yeah.
Oh, I figured out the advice I wanted for before. It was... I don't know the word for it, but it's basically like being a yes man. If that makes sense.
Yeah,
like, it's
no,
hard
I
for
got
me to
that.
Say no.
Yeah.
Is there a word... Was there a word for that?
Sycophant?
Sycophant, yeah.
Maybe you
what is
be
the...
a, maybe you should be a bastard as well, Anosh. How amazing would that be? You're actually the younger brother of the knight that you follow around, Hendrick Stone.
Yeah.
How many total base benefits do you get?
I think it's 3 for you guys, but I would go back and check on page like 68.
So that's 3 base plus 1 for each flaw?
Well, every benefit you take uses a destiny point, so...
Young adults have maximum of 3, and adults have maximum of 3. And yes, each of them takes destiny points. There's no, like, you don't automatically start with any. You just have to buy them.
So also, I'm asking if I can take a 4th benefit if I take a flaw.
Yep.
Okay, cool.
As long as you... Yeah, I mean, like, you have to have spent a benefit first, right? Because you can't have more flaws than benefits.
Yeah.
So you're going to end up having 2 benefits and 1 flaw.
I've got 4 benefits and 1 flaw.
Well, then that's great.
Cruel insanity.
You sure you don't want to take that?
As a healer, like, he must live! Even if it must be with the boar's leg.
You are obviously the one who has spent lots of time investigating this and optimizing. What benefit should I be looking at?
No!
Yeah.
No. That's completely the wrong way to play. Don't be like, man, I want to min-max my play. Don't do that.
Oh yeah. Are we going to do the dwarf thing?
Dwarf.
Dwarf. Everybody dwarf.
I feel like this is definitely going to be like, everyone's like, yeah, I'm a eunuch, I'm a dwarf, I take all these shitty flaws, so I can take benefits like amazing sword fighter.
No, I only took the flaw because I had to.
Yeah, I know. I'm looking at Eric.
I'm just trying to figure out what... I haven't read through any of the benefits, so I'm trying to figure out
He's
what...
He's like, I'm deaf! But I don't need that to sword fight.
No, I'm
also,
not taking
I'm cursed
any additional
and I have a
flaws.
Scar, but now I have 8 sword fighting. And I also have 8 sword test die. Ah, I'm the greatest sword fighter ever!
He has As I currently have him lied out, he is fighting 6, long blade, 4B.
Fighting 6 is already ridiculous. And 4B, what?
I told you, his entire goal is excellence.
Okay, so after you get...
I want to be the very best.
Like this fear.
Make them roll. I can't make them roll on this one. You sure you don't want to take the flaw supreme arrogance, Eric? Your arrogance blinds you to the danger swirling all about you.
I'm just trying to figure out what I should add, given that I to make up for the bastard, because I already decided I was going to be one.
What's in the... Oh, so, the sequel...
Blade fighter plus one.
The sequel fan wasn't exactly the word I was looking for.
Okay.
Ooh, the sequel fan seems to, like... seek advantage of the other person, like acting like, yes, yeah, I'll do it, but you're like trying to get advantage of them, is what it sounds like. Like a bootlicker. That's not what I was thinking. I was just looking at yes, man. Let's see if there's a
yes, man.
Okay. Blood of Heroes totally makes sense for this guy. So.
No.
Blood of just going to put yes, man. So I'd let you do.
Exceed 7 limit on a specific ability.
Oh.
So. If he survives long enough, he's just going to invest all of his experience in being the best. I mean, that's what his goal is. It's totally character consistent.
Yeah, but you made your character. No.
Blood of...
No break game now.
No. Ability. You may spend experience to increase this ability beyond 7. Sure, but you have to tell me what hero you came from. You're basically setting your entire house up for being a noble line. Come on, buddy.
I have no idea who the heroes are.
Heroes come from the Age of Heroes.
Right.
Yeah, I'm going to make up your hero for you, buddy. And you have to live up to his... Obviously, he was a sword fighter of some sort.
The Arthur Dean, Sword of the Morning.
I prefer the Black Star.
You could
I've always like... felt like I like to. I really like to min-max things that don't break the game, but like I offer an interesting character. Like when I'm in Pathfinder, I really loved my friend who had a con, like super high character that wasn't really good at fighting. If that makes sense, because like you can last forever in the combat, but you're just not contributing.
Like I've gone with a balanced character, and I'm trying to figure out what you guys are not so great at, and trying to like.
If you want to see what I'm doing, it's on the house creation.
Like I've got pretty decent persuasion. It's only a 3, but I get bonus dice on persuasion. Against 1 bonus dice against everyone on persuasion, and I get to reroll 1 on my persuasion roll.
Cool.
So just like I. Hopefully you'll be decent at it. Like I won't be fantastic or anything. Yeah.
Alright, so we get
ones in life.